All right. Okay. This is series 6 of Song Nerds. Glad you're here. Song Nerds is a archive, a documentary of my new working style of working sans the computer, without the computer. Completely what you would call DAWless. Thanks for being here. Now, what I intend to do with this series is just go over the song process, the music making process in its early stages. And today we're going to talk about a concept of the undercurrent. There's many aliases for this word. You can call it ambience. You can call it just overall gel that you can put in electronic music to make it sound more natural. Now, here's what I mean when I say natural. Electronic music, by nature of the way it's produced, is essentially anechoic. It does not interact with the real world until it actually comes through speakers and hits your ears. And that means when it's played, it is lacking space, depth, interaction with other sounds. So for contrast, if a vocalist sings, she will sing in a room, and that room will interact with her voice. Her voice will bounce off the walls. Her body will resonate on a whole. Sound will be emanating from all parts of her and interacting with the atmosphere that she's in. That will then determine how we hear it at the point of source, whether that be a microphone or our ears, if we're listening to live music, and ultimately recorded onto a fixed medium. With electronic music, that doesn't happen. The way the sounds occur is how they're heard. And the only way to create an undercurrent, an interaction with the real world, can only occur when we hear it or if we create an undercurrent within the sound, right? Or make the sounds react with other sounds to have a sort of undercurrent. And that's what we're looking at today. Now, how do we do this? We can either do the most simple thing, which is to basically create space by using algorithms like reverb, delay, things like that, that are specifically designed to compensate for the fact that these sounds lack space, right? However, another way to do it is to create an undercurrent, create a moving sort of background noise, a murmur, an aliveness to the music that runs in the song, but is not necessarily intended to dominate or be something that's really consciously noted in the music, right? So what I've done here is I'm going to display a technique of creating an undercurrent. Don't worry, we'll get to the point where we hear things. But the main group that I'd like to note as masters of creating undercurrent, especially in hip-hop music as we know it historically, would be the Bomb Squad, notably for their work on Public Enemy. They were masters of creating sample-based undercurrent, just ruckus and noise under the music that would lend to the music and make it really, really feel alive. If you listen to any of Public Enemy's music, it just sounds like it's just really alive, like really, really electric, even though it's all sample-based music for the most part. So here's what I've done. I'm gonna play my sounds. The first is this here. Very low sub kick. The second is this. Just a sound, and these are sound designed samples that have been developed by me just for this purpose. And I don't know what this is. Modulated sample. So you see, these are sounds that I've made, and I've caused them to change within this device here, which is the Electron Octatrack, to be very random and very sort of erratic, right? And the last one, let's take a listen. Right? Very, very, very unstable, moving, let's just stop it there, moving sound. And at this stage, I've opted not to use reverb. I've opted not to use any artificial space. I'm creating my own sort of undercurrent by using these sounds that are very erratic and sort of spontaneous, and I've arranged them so that they're going to play together. And I'm going to use this to run throughout the track that I'm going to make, right? So let's just listen to how I've programmed them to play together. Right? So that is my undercurrent. Now, what do I do with this? I take this and I'm going to build on top of it. So this is going to be sort of the heart, the pulse of the music, but it's going to be so well disguised and buried in the music that it's really not going to be functional as a highlight piece. It's going to literally be an undercurrent. But what it does is it will convey to the listener that the music is alive, that it's moving, that there's something not so programmed and robotic about it, right? It's going to seem to breathe on its own, right? You see, that is undercurrent. And you do this to make the music seem more human. The problem that we have with electronic music songs is that we are missing largely the acoustic element. So much so that another technique that I would describe here of things that we do to compensate to make our sounds sound alive is to actually take our sample sounds and record them acoustically through something like an amplifier. So you take your samples, play them through a speaker, and then record it back. On my song Gold Revelation, that 12-inch, that's what I did. I essentially had the drums recorded in a sampler similar to this. I took them, played them through a speaker, and then recorded them with a mic in my kitchen just to get some, you know, live elements of air in there. The sound traveling through the air, hitting the microphone, and then heading back to tape so that I can record it. And that gave it more of a live element as opposed to playing just in its own isolated area. So that is undercurrent. And that is how we as artists that work with samples compensate for the fact that we don't have acoustic space most of the time. We create it artificially, but another way to do it is to add an undercurrent, a moving pulse. Just like when you head outside at any time of day or night and you just listen, there's all sorts of noises. Cars driving by in the distance, birds singing, wind blowing, there's an undercurrent going on. And that is what we try to add here in the music, to add an element of something other than silence, right? That's all I wanted to share here on Song Nerds. Hope this wasn't a little bit too technical for you, but it's sort of one of the more finer aspects or nuances of electronic music that I wanted to discuss here. However, what you can do while you're here is head over to thedaydreamsound.com, listen to my music, get signed up to the mailing list, and stay tuned. Once again, this song here will be part of the collection that I'm working on now, of these, you know, songs that I'm working on, Dawless. And when the album is released, that is where the news will be broken first. I will catch you on the next one. Thanks for joining me here on Song Nerds. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.